Let's review the balance sheet. So the balance sheet is one of four financial statements, and it's the third one that you prepare. So a balance sheet would look something like this. First, you list out all of your assets. Your assets have to be listed in order of liquidity. That's how quickly you can turn it to cash or how quickly you're going to use up that asset. Then, once you list all of your assets, you total them so that way you have your total assets. Once you find that, then you move on to the next part of the balance sheet, your liabilities and owner's equity. So we will list out our liabilities, then we list out our owner's capital under the owner's equity umbrella, and we total up our liabilities and owner's equity. Now our total assets need to equal our total liabilities and owner's equity. Because if we think back to the accounting equation, that says your assets equals liabilities plus owner's equity. So now we're just proving that in a financial statement. So in this example, it says the following balances are for Bowman Inc. on April 30th, 2020. We have cash, accounts receivable, equipment, accumulated depreciation equipment, accounts payable, and owner's capital. And we need to prepare a balance sheet on April 30th. So if you take a look on the right side of your screen right now, it says Bowman Inc., that's the company name, balance sheet, that's the financial statement that you're preparing, and then it just says April 30th, 2020. A balance sheet is a snapshot in time, so it's just the date that you prepare it rather than what we see on the income statement and owner's equity with for the month ended or for the year ended. So now we start listing out all of our assets. And again, these have to be listed out in order of liquidity. So cash is already cash. That's always going to be your most liquid asset. So we list out cash. Next up is your accounts receivable. Then our equipment. And you'll notice the number for the equipment, that 90,000, went to the inside. Why is that? Well, we have this accumulated depreciation on that equipment, this contra asset account. It's going to decrease the book value of our equipment. So we're going to subtract out that accumulated depreciation and then put the book value over on the far right in line with our cash and accounts receivable amounts. So if we take 20,000 plus 10,000 plus our 75,000, we find our total assets to be $105,000. Now we can move on to the liabilities and owner's equity section. So we first list out our liabilities. Well, we only have one of those. We only had accounts payable. So we'll put accounts payable, 20,000. Then we list out our owner's equity account. The account is owner's capital. So that's 85,000. Which means our total liabilities and owner's equity adds up to $105,000. So you'll notice our assets do equal our liabilities plus owner's equity.